Welcome along to Krasnoyarsk in Siberia and the fun park Bobroy vlog for the 29th Winter Universiade. It is day one of the Alpine competition and it is men's Super G day here in Siberia. Glorious day as the men look to win their first medal of this Winter Universiade, and preparations are almost finished. The last sharpening of the edges for a piece that has been watered, injected with water from top to bottom. There are the conditions just below freezing, and the snow still cold. The sun is out and the shadows being cast across this piece by the trees flanked on either side. Very narrow piece and a race of two halves. The top half is steep and turny, bottom half is more of a gliding section, and you can see there just over 1.5 kilometers. Let's have a look at the skier's view, and here are the key turns. This is the key top turn, hard on this left ski, and you've got to stay high in the line around this blue gate over the roller. It was a jump until yesterday, but too many skiers getting too much air, so they shaved it off. And at the bottom part, this long gliding section, super, super important for the athletes to stay on the bases of their skis and keep the speed going for the bottom third of this section. Too many errors on the steep section and you won't carry enough speed onto this flatter section and time will bleed away. So here is the starting list for this men's Super G. 63 racers from 25 National Olympic committees. The top 15 seeded racers going from bibs 1 to 15, they were drawn at random yesterday, and then from 16 all the way through to 61, they go on your FIS points numbers, and 62 and 63 were drawn at random as they have no official Super G finishes under their belt. Jan Zavistran of the Czech Republic, the next to go. Zavistran, second in an FIS Super G in January in the Czech Republic, and just a little wide off the hard left footer. And he is half a second though, the right side of the clock. The Czech racer trying to accelerate out of every turn, carving the turn rather than sliding it. 38.96. Zavistran is looking quick and he's extended that lead now to 0.82 of a second. Zavistran comes towards the end of the challenge, 59.21. We are going to have ourselves a new leader by nearly a second, 58.23, and a little acknowledgement from Zavistran. Number three, Lukas Zippert of Switzerland. 20 years of age, he's raced 5 Super Gs on the Europa Cup and goes around that like he's on rails. A lovely turn from Zippert. Best of 44th in Wengen back in 2018. And he's 0.2 the right side of the clock. Zippert driving the hands forward, driving the weight forward. Look how little snow comes off the edges of his skis. He carves these turns. And it grows to 0.78, the right side of the clock. This is a competitive time from Zippert, it would seem. And Zippert leads by over a second, 57.04. That is an excellent run from the 20-year-old.
I love that pull on it off. Yeah, Tommy, I know!
Philip Steinvall of Sweden, the next to go, 21 years of age. nice and high to try and be as direct as possible down the full line on that left-footed turn. How's he faring? 21.01, and he is a third of a second the wrong side of the clock. And he's got to try and find time on this middle section, because once he gets past his second intermediate, very difficult to pull that time back. 37.36. Almost doubled his deficit. The blue dye on the side of the course, just a guide really for the racers. Don't have to stay in that if you don't want to. As a general rule, you'll be skiing longer distances. So 57.39, well, he found time. He has found time on the bottom, and that will be interesting to see. Jansson of Sweden, the next to go. Made his Europa Cup debut in Wengen this year in a downhill. He won a Super G FIS race in Norway this year. Also second in Norway consecutive days. Maybe 7.36, 1.21. Deficit has grown from 0.55 to 1.21. We did see Steinhall pick some time up on the bottom, and indeed Jansson cannot, and he will drop into fourth position.
Det var rätt bra.
So top three.
Hey, Erik!
5, 4, 3, 2.
Yannick Dobler of Switzerland, the next to go. Dobler hard on that left ski. Nicely done. Those two Europa Cup Super G's last season, the Europa Cup being the level just below the World Cup. And 0.34 is in touch, but he won't want to lose too much more time on his compatriot Sipet. We've seen 0.33 gain between intermediate two and the finish. So Dobler with little, if anything, to play with, and he's now finds himself 0.9 off the pace. Dobler, we need to find two-thirds of a second to go into second place. Two gates from home, 58.12. And the second off the pace, Dobler goes third. Sabistrad off the podium.
Hi.
Yannick Chabrol of Switzerland. Won two FIS races. Downhill discipline and one in Super G back in January in Switzerland. And we'll be looking to get as close as he can to Zipper, 21.01. Oh, and it is very close, this 9/100ths of a second for Chabrol to try and find. Got to try and stay in that top position. Next time split, 37.36, and he's outside it. He's gone out to half a second. Chabrol is going to be struggling to pull this one back. He could make the podium. He needs to find nearly 0.2 to make it into second spot. Chabrol touch for the line, 57.33. Good enough for second. Switzerland sit 1 and 2. Stefan Fanhauser from the University of Salzburg, the first of the Austrians to challenge. Austria, of course, with such a rich pedigree in alpine ski racing, as does Switzerland. Can Fanhauser negotiate those crucial turns well? Well, it doesn't look too bad from here. clock will tell us he's 2/10 the wrong side from his point of view of Zippert's time. Podium now just separated by 35 hundredths, so Van Houser needs to be in touch here. 37.36 and 0.8. He's asking a lot from the Austrian. The only Austrian in the top 15, which is the top seeds. Stefan Van Houser taps for the line. And he will stop the clock. 58.09. He slides into fourth position. A little shake of the head from Van Houser.
Hey, how was it?
10 seconds.
Bib number 10. Arnaud Boisset of Switzerland. And third in a Europa Cup downhill in Chamonix in January. Seventh at the Junior World Championships in Italy 2 weekends ago. Now, be fair here on these top turns. It looks quick. What will the clock say? Oh, just opens up a little bit, 6/100ths the wrong side of the clock, but there was a big error there. You saw a big plume of smoke came into that red gate too direct and had to put too much of a turn in. I would be surprised if he's close on the second split, which would be 37.36. I think that mistake has cost him. And he's 2/3 of a second the wrong side of the clock. Boisset was flying on the top, but just that error coming on to the gliding section. Shave too much speed off. 57.04. 0.36. He misses out on the podium by 1/100th of a second.
Five, four,
in the start out now.
Two,
it's Ben Florjančič of Slovenia. Now he is the highest rated skier in this men's Super G field. And so the leaders, the podium, will be looking up the hill to see how he fares. So far, so good for Florjančič. 21.01, he's a quarter of a second, the wrong side of the clock. So work to do for the number one ranked skier. Can he find time on this middle section? 37.36, the next time split, and he's away from it, you know. He's away from it by 2/3 of a second, so Florjančič might not bring home that number one label here in this men's Super G. Final few turns of the challenge for him, and I think Zippert has seen off the challenge. 5.53 off the pace. Florjančič disappointed. So Lukas Zippert leads the way from Yannick Schablo. Sweden in third. Paul Perrier, University of Savoie Mont Blanc in France, leads the start out, and Perrier will have got plenty of information from the coaches down the side of the track. 21.01, he's in touch, 1/3 of a second. Now, can he find time in this middle section? That'll be the key. Just got opened up a little bit there over that terrain change. That will have caught some air in his body, and that could be what? 0.05, 1/10 of a second. Oh, it's a lot more than that. Look at that. It has grown to over a second for Perrier. Not to be, I don't think, for the Frenchman today. Perrier, 58.33, goes to 9th, 1.29 off the pace. Switzerland continue to lead the way.
The start interval is 1 minute 20 seconds.
Tomáš Kinský from the Czech Republic. The next to go, made his World Cup debut this year in the Wengen downhill in the Lauberhorn of all places. couldn't finish on that occasion. That was Klinsky fairing here. And again, he looks quick across the snow, but he's a third of a second off the pace. Klinsky with a second time split. Sees his deficit grow to 0.53. Podium is possible here if he can find speed. The most time we've seen gained on that bottom half is 0.33 of a second, so that would get him into second spot if he can find it. And the answer is he can. He's found a lot of time and goes second, 2/10 off the pace, Zabistrand.
5, 4, 3,
Ivan Kuznetsov, of Russia, the next to go. What can Kuznetsov do here? Kuznetsov driving those hands forward. He looks quick. Oh, yes, well, he's a quarter of a second off the pace, but he's keeping that tough position. Kuznetsov trying to steal the gold away from Switzerland and Lukas Zipper. If he can be within 3/10 here, he's got a chance. 0.73, I'm afraid it's gone for Kuznetsov. 0.33, still the most amount of time we've seen gained between intermediate two and the bottom. And Kuznetsov, three gates from home, being cheered home by the local supporters. 58.03 goes seventh place. Ado Echezarreta of Spain, the next to go, the last of the top seeds, raced at the World Championships last month in order. Sweden was 40th in the downhill, didn't finish the Super G. Can he bring some speed here? 0.26, the wrong side of the clock. This is going to have to be an exceptional ski from the Spaniard from this point on if he's to take the gold away. Echezarreta coming to the next split, and he's 0.64 off the pace. Just about possible to get a podium, but he's got to ski like a man possessed to get within 0.29 of Zipper. Echezarreta stops the clock, 57.55, 0.51 off the pace, and he slides into sixth place.
Oh, we are in the room.
Bib 16, Tommaso Canclini of Italy, the next to go. Canclini, win on the CIT Tour in Super C. Slipped a little out of line on that difficult combination, and he's down. Canclini is down, a little punch of the ground, disappointment. What happened? Just gets caught on the inside ski. He would be furious with himself. In eighth. Andre Jedzic. Next to go from Poland. Racers leaving the start up every minute now, so we don't get to see all the run. Jedzic's 0.65 off the pace at the top, now sees it grow to a second. Goes eight, finds some time. 16/100 on the bottom part of the challenge.
All right, it's
There's no problem.
Yeah,
Babitsky And next to go, Babitski. Skating out of the start hut. 23 years of age, Babitski. Sixth in the Universiade Games 2 years ago in Almaty. 4-4, he's going to 0.86. Well, that's good enough for a top 15 finish, but can he find any more time on this bottom challenge? A third of a second is the most we've seen Claude back. Babitski, yeah, finds the top 10. Goes ninth, good skiing. And we have finished the men's Super G here in Krasnoyarsk. Crowd are all happy. Here are the official results then. Lukasz Zippert of Switzerland takes the gold medal in the men's Super G here at the Winter Universiade. Tomáš Klinský of the Czech Republic in second place. And Yannick Schablo of Switzerland wins the bronze. The top three separated by just 0.29 of a second. The best of the Russian racers, Ivan Kuznetsov, who came home in 10th position, 0.99 off the pace of Lukasz Zippert.
Third place representing Switzerland, Yannick Schablo. Second place, representing Czech Republic, Tomáš Klinský.
Tomáš, very good. Thank you.
First place, representing Switzerland, Lukasz Zippert.
But here at the men's Super G, it's Switzerland who are celebrating. Lukasz Zippert is our champion. Well, that's it from day one of these Winter Universiade Games. What a day we've had in the Super G. Do join us tomorrow for what should be an epic day two.